Given the function y equals tangent of the product of 7 and the sum of x and pi divided by 3, determine the period, horizontal shift, and equations of the vertical asymptotes. Use n to represent any integer. Notice the equation is in the form of y equals a times tangent of the product of b and the quantity x minus c plus d. Let's begin by determining the values of a, b, c, and d. Notice a, the coefficient, is 1. B is 7. We need to be careful when identifying c. The binomial has to be in the form of x minus c, because we have x plus pi divided by 3, c equals negative pi divided by 3. Recall that x plus pi divided by 3 is equivalent to x minus negative pi divided by 3. And then finally, d is equal to 0. Recall the period of the basic tangent function is pi, not 2 pi, which is why the formula for the period for the tangent function is pi divided by the absolute value of b, which means in our case the period is pi divided by 7, or if we want, 1/7 pi. The horizontal shift, or phase shift, is determined by the value of c. Because c is negative pi divided by 3, or less than 0, the function is translated left the absolute value of c units, or left pi divided by 3 units. And next we're going to determine the equations of the vertical asymptotes. Let's first review the basic tangent function shown below. We should remember we have vertical asymptotes at x equals pi divided by 2, x equals 3 pi divided by 2, and to the left, x equals negative pi divided by 2, and x equals negative 3 pi divided by 2. The equations of the vertical asymptotes are x equals pi divided by 2 plus pi times n, where n is any integer. Notice pi divided by 2 is half the period, so if we think of starting at x equals 0 and then adding half the period, notice we get the location of one vertical asymptote, which is x equals pi divided by 2. Once we find one vertical asymptote, we simply add the multiples of the period, which is why we also include plus pi times n. Notice when n is 1, we have pi divided by 2 plus pi, which gives us x equals 3 pi divided by 2. And now if we look at the formula given for the vertical asymptotes with the tangent function in the form shown above, it also accommodates for the horizontal shift, or phase shift, given by the value of c. We begin with x equals pi divided by the product of 2 and the absolute value of b, which is half of the period, but then we add c to accommodate for the horizontal or phase shift. This part gives us the equation of one vertical asymptote, and then we add multiples of the period given by pi divided by the absolute value of b times n, where again n is any integer. So for our function, we have x equals pi divided by the product of 2 and the absolute value of b gives us 2 times 7, and then plus c gives us plus negative pi divided by 3, or just minus pi divided by 3. This would be the equation for one vertical asymptote, and then we add multiples of the period given by plus pi divided by 7 times n. Let's go and subtract these fractions by obtaining a common denominator, which is going to be 14 times 3, or 42. To obtain a common denominator, we multiply the first fraction by 3 over 3, multiply the second fraction by 14 over 14. This gives us x equals 3 pi minus 14 pi, all divided by 42, plus pi divided by 7 times n. Let's go and simplify one more time and write the equations as x equals 3 pi minus 14 pi is negative 11 pi, giving us x equals negative 11 pi divided by 42 plus pi divided by 7 times n for the equations for the vertical asymptotes. And let's check this graphically. Using Desmos, in blue we have the graph of the given function. Using the equations for the vertical asymptotes, notice when n is 0, we have x equals negative 11 pi divided by 42. When n is 1, we have x equals negative 11 pi divided by 42 plus pi divided by 7. When n is 2, we have x equals negative 11 pi divided by 42 plus 2 pi divided by 7, and so on. Notice these equations do give us the vertical asymptotes for the given tangent function. I hope you found this helpful.